Hi, it's Jeannie. Thanks for coming back to my channel. And if it's your first time, welcome. And if you've been here before, welcome back. Please hit like and subscribe and help me grow my channel. And today I'm going to show you some cool and interesting things that maybe you've seen, maybe you haven't. If you've ever traveled on an airplane, and if you've had the privilege to be in first class or business, depending on the kind of airplane, you will have seen certain goodies in the seats of those who fly first class. And I have a whole bunch of various things to show you because they go through different iterations of what they give out to their passengers. And so the reason I have so many of them is because my husband, now retired, was a pilot, a captain for a major airline, and I had the privilege of flying all around the world with him, sometimes while he was a working crew member, and sometimes just for pleasure. So these little first class goodies were on the seats as we would come into the airplane. And there are little things that you just need throughout the flight. Perhaps if you don't want to get into your baggage or your suitcase stored above to get these little goodies out, little amenities that make the trip a little bit easier. On one of the flights from San Francisco to Singapore, we actually got pajamas because it was such a long flight. Everyone in first class was offered a pair of pajamas and they were very comfortable. And I did bring those home because I wore them. That flight was 17 and a half hours, I believe. And it was a long, long haul. And I consider myself very fortunate to have had a lie flat bed. I don't know that I could do that trip sitting in a chair, maybe when I was younger. So anyway, let's go ahead and get started here, and I will begin to show you what's inside these first class amenity bags. So the first amenities bag that I'll show you is this plain leather looking bag, but it's a vinyl of some sort. And there is no logo on the outside, but on the inside, you can see in the lining that this is a United amenities bag, and they feature Saks Fifth Avenue linens and pillows, and they're very nice, let me tell you. So the first thing is this eye mask. And this is really important if you do sleep on flights, particularly long flights. They turn the lights off in most of the cabin areas, but bathroom lights come on, reading lights come on, all kinds of little things. And I'm very sensitive to light when I sleep. It's like I can almost feel it. So I like darkness. So I always wear one of these. And Polaris is the name of their business first class cabin. Okay, the second thing I pull out is the cow shed products that are inside here. smelling towelette to wash your face or your hands. They have a chapstick because typically airplanes are very dehydrating, so it's good to have something like this. And then a very nice hand cream. So that's a very nice little bonus. And then a toothbrush and toothpaste, cute little toothpaste. And there's enough in here for more than just the flight. Thing I like about their toothbrushes is they have a little case to put the bristle end back in, so that way I can put it back in here or put it in a pocket in my purse and the bristles stay relatively clean. These socks. These are cute in this black and gray stripe. And these are important for slipping on if you have to walk down the aisle to the lav, or if you want to get up and walk around and you don't want to put your shoes on. You definitely want to have something on your feet. And these are great to have just for that purpose, or just for wearing at your seat if it's a little bit drafty or cold and you don't want to put your shoes on. Keeps your feet a little bit warmer. Reminds me of those old-time cartoons with the jail outfits being black and white stripes. And the last couple of items would be a pen. It looks like it fell out of its container here. And earplugs. These are important. When I fly, what I like to do is I'll put in either my AirPods with my Bose headphones over just to drown out any noise, and I'll put on very, very quiet classical music or very soft music. If I don't bring my AirPods, I'll use these with the headphones over them. It just gives an extra layer of quiet. This is the first bag. Script. Very usable for other items without screaming airline on it. So, is this small brown canvas type bag. And this is from Lufthansa. And I believe Picard was an airman, an awarded airman. And I don't know a lot about that. This also is a very nice size to reuse. First thing we pull out is a pair of socks. And again, these are great for walking down the aisle, keeping your feet clean. Or just keeping your feet warm if it's drafty at your seat. Eye mask, and here you see the Lufthansa bird. Sometimes you'll hear somebody pronounce it Lufthansa because of the TH, but it's Lufthansa, Lufthansa. Francisco to Germany. I'll have my meal, watch a movie, and then I get ready to lay down or snuggle up and go to sleep, and I wash my face and take off my makeup so my face is clean and I don't get makeup all over or my face. Next thing is the toothbrush and toothpaste. And it's a pretty big toothpaste. And it's a full-size toothbrush. What they do not have is that cover for putting it away and keeping it clean and free from debris. But that's okay. These are only for temporary use. And then the last item are the earplugs. And they are squishy and fit into your ear canal. first class, business first, on United. One that's already open, so I'll show you this. This one is slightly different than the one that was in the plastic. Doesn't say business first. What I like about these are they have this nifty hanger to use, so when you go into the lab or restroom, you can hang it up. And if you'll notice on airplanes, in the labs, on the backs of the door or somewhere on the wall, they typically have a pull-out hook. These have nice mesh, see-through linings. And first thing is a lens cleaner, and it's a microfiber cloth, and you use this for your glasses, or your phone screen, or your laptop, or iPad, or reader. You do not want to use something rougher than this, because you could scratch it. If you are in need of a shaving product, a razor or shave cream, they are available upon request. You just need to contact the flight attendant. It's a nice touch. And we've got a little box of mints. Mojito, which is lime and peppermint flavored, and this nice lip balm. Very nice, because sometimes on long flights you tend to get dehydrated, and so this is a nice little touch. Here is the toothbrush and toothpaste, and a nice cover for the bristles of the toothbrush, so it'll stay clean. a pen, a full size pen. Often when you fly overseas, you have to fill out customs paperwork. And if you don't have a pen handy, there's one in your amenities bag. And then a little package of tissues. I often take these out and put them in my purse because it's the perfect size for that occasional tissue need. On this side, is a bergamot, honey, hand and body lotion. A brush or a comb. There's nothing worse, well, relatively speaking, than falling asleep and you wake up and you go into the lab and you look in the mirror and your hair is sticking up and you don't have a comb with you. And then again, the socks, and these are just a plain grayish blue. Just enough to keep your feet clean or warm. Now, I do believe there were a couple of other things in here that we used or took out, and that would have been mouthwash and a sanitizing liquid. text bag, I'll show you, is quite nice. And this is from when there was a global first on United. And global first was typically a three cabin aircraft like the 747 or the 777, where their very front nose area was global first. And I loved global first. But they've done away with that, and it's now Polaris, as I said earlier. This is a wonderful bag. And it's got the loop here, so if you take it into the lab, you can hang it up. It's got a nice snap. And when you open it, you've got the two compartments with that mesh. And pull out again the lens wipe for glasses, phone, or computer, or laptop screens. These are peppermint. There's two peppermints in each container. Those are usually the first things I get into. And then we've got the toothpaste and the toothbrush. And this toothbrush has an entire case in it that you turn into a full-size brush. I like this case. I've got lots of these, and I use them for travel or overnight stays somewhere. And a little container of hand sanitizer. A bottle of Scope mouthwash. This is nice for refreshing your breath after or during a long flight. Long flights tend to make your mouth dry out and just feel pretty gnarly. So between this and brushing your teeth, you should feel pretty. Very nice, but I don't think I could cover my hair with this. this would do somehow. And of course, the earplugs. And the facial tissue. And that is all on this side. And on this side, we have the eye mask, but what's extra nice with this one is this big plush, oh my goodness, look at this nice plush eye mask. It is so soft. So nice. I personally would put this one on and then put this one on over just to block out any possible light. But that is so, so soft. It's such a pretty color blue. And a nice little addition is a shoehorn. Help get your shoes on when it's time to land. That is a nice touch. I don't know that I would necessarily need it, but I suppose there are people who would. And then the sock. And these are wrapped in a cute ribbon that say United. And they're just the plain colored blue socks with a little bit of grippy stuff on the bottom. But that little ribbon is a very nice touch, don't you think? I believe there was also a pen that went right here, but I probably used it and didn't put it back. Next amenity, the next amenity kit pays homage to the 747, which is no longer in the fleet as they've retired that airplane. was my favorite airplane. It had three classes. Coach, business first, and first. But they also had global first, which was very nice. And the beds, the light flat beds, were fantastic. They also had an upstairs area that was part of business first. One that is already open, so I won't open this one. Now this is a dark blue. And the one I have that's already open is kind of a bright blue, kind of a royal blue. And it celebrates the 747. This graphic here. The 747 was no longer very efficient in terms of the expense for gas versus the cost of tickets and whatnot. And as wonderful as of an airplane as it was, it just became outdated. She was called the Queen of the Skies. I love this case, but it does not make for easy traveling because it doesn't collapse because of the rigidity of the case. But it was a temporary design. So we've got the pen. We've got the earplugs. The facial tissues. This is sanitizer. This is the chamomile towelette for washing your face or your hands, and these socks. And look, they've got the 747 emblem plus that graphic that they used. They have some information about the 747 and celebrating it. Just really paying a beautiful homage to the Queen of the Skies. The eye mask. This is a calming and relaxing pillow spray, and it smells really lovely. Kind of like lavender and mint. Very relaxing, very nice and calming. The lip balm. And last but not least, the hand cream. Pressurized from the last flight. I've had this for quite a while. Oh, that still smells fantastic. As I mentioned before, we will often give these to our grandkids and put them in like stocking stuffers or at Christmas, or bring them with us when we go to visit them. Okay, the next one. Cinches up, and you can like carry it like a purse or wear it on your back to carry some extra items or use it as a laundry bag. So I love these colors, and inside these socks. Oh my goodness, look how cute these are. So they're the striped, red and white stripes. And they've got the blue stars that are kind of gummy and grippy. Aren't those cute? Those are just precious. I love these. And they're right in the theme. Red, white, and blue. This is the lip balm, the cream, and I believe the spray. But I'm not going to open it because we don't have too many of these. And these were pretty special, so I'm going to try to preserve it. And we've got earplugs. And the tissues. And I just love this theme that they kept throughout all of these products. box inside. Last but not least of the bags that I grabbed is this one. This is the gray and the blue, and like the other one is a sack without the arm holds, and this was for the PGA, Pacific Golf Association, official airline of the PGA Tour. This is a great bag, and it's got the lining done in a blue and green and black argyle. So I'm not going to open this. Said it's a kind of a collector's item, but you can see some of the products inside. This special one has golf balls. Argyle socks. Ear plugs. Toothbrush. Pen, tissues, lip balm, cream, toothbrush and toothpaste, and just about everything that the others had. So these were some of the first class and business class amenity bags that we had on one of the shelves in the closet that I wanted to share with you. Tell me what you think in the comments below. I hope this was relaxing and you were able to tune out from the noise and the stress of the day. And as I often say, mindless things to focus on that help us get to sleep. fun.